Today is a very special day. I first came into contact with Memoria Viva 4 or 5 years ago when they were looking for a home for their archives. And over that time, we built a relationship, and I'm very pleased that this has all come to fruition today. And of course, today is September 10th. Tomorrow, September 11th, is the 45th anniversary of the Pinochet coup d'etat in Chile. That will be commemorated at a separate event tomorrow. But we wanted to start this event at 11 a.m. to have a symbolic nod to the 11th, to El 11. Hopefully I pronounced that correctly. Thank you to our special guests today, the Honorable Ricardo Miranda, Minister of Culture and Tourism, MLA Rod Loyola, the MLA for Edmonton Ellerslie, and Member of Parliament Linda Duncan, MP for Edmonton Strathcona. Thank you very much for being here. It means very much to us and to a Memoria Viva. We're going to start the program with a song from Daniel Villalobos, who learned the guitar in his teen years and through the Canto Nuevo by Victor Jara found the chords that taught him of justice and equality. The music in those days was his first contact with the canto libre of the arts and socialist thoughts. This presentation is dedicated to Victor Jara's legacy and to all who have fought for a better, more equal world. Thank you.
Buenos dias, good day everyone. First of all, thanks 26 for allowing us in this land, how brave and set. And secondly, a great thanks to the government of Canada and Alberta to allow us to share this culture with them and to leave this imprinted in the history for years to come. So my kids, your kids, so we can all keep learning from the history and how important it is to never forget. So the song I'm going to start today with, it's a song from Victor Jara called Plegaria a un Labrador, which states how important it is that we have to have that contact with nature and how important it is to use our two hands for the best that we can do as human beings. So Victor Jara, Plegaria a un Labrador.
Levántate y mírate las manos para crecer, estrecha la tu hermano. Juntos iremos unidos en la sangre, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Amén. Amén.
Siempre presente. Gracias.
Thank you very much, Daniel. Next, I'd like to introduce Sergio Olivares of the Memoria Viva Society. Sergio was born in Chile in 1973. His parents are survivors of the brutal military coup that took place on September 11th, 1973. Sergio was involved in solidarity work from his birth. His parents are activists who pressured many organizations towards better human rights, not only in Chile, but around the world. Many of the meetings would take place in their family living room, and the activities were part of his fabric of living. At the age of 10, Sergio began to volunteer on the program called Nosotros. There, he learned how media can give a voice to people who are not heard. Later on, Sergio rose to the top ranks of camera operators in Canada, winning awards for his work. And today, he's the president of Memoria Viva Society of Edmonton and the owner of Red Star Productions. Sergio?
First off, I just want to say thank you to all our Indigenous brothers and sisters for sharing this land with us. We are on Treaty 6, and we give big thanks to our brothers, not just here in Canada, but all over the world. I want to start by acknowledging todos mis tíos, mis tías, los compañeros, mis compañeras. This is one of the first schools made here. It's Escuela Salvador Allende, and it takes the name of Salvador Allende. Salvador Allende was a democratically elected president of Chile that was brutally killed on September 11, 1973. We here in Canada lived in exile, but now that spirit, that why we came and why we fought for human rights, for the struggle for solidarity, not just for Chile, but all over Latin America, has never stopped. Why doesn't it stop? It doesn't stop because if we stop telling our history, history will repeat itself. And we're seeing that now in different parts of Latin America, different parts of the world. So this doesn't stop. Today doesn't stop yesterday. It stops when we stop talking about it. So the minute that we stop remembering what's going on is the minute that this repeats itself. So we cannot do that. That's why we established a Memoria Viva Society, the archive. The archive is to tell the story of our tios and tias. What did they do? What did they do? They got together and they made schools. They got together and they did meetings. They did parties. They did sporting events. And why? It's to build capacity. How do you build capacity? You bring people together with like minds, with the spirit of human rights, with the spirit of solidarity. And that blueprint we cannot lose, but it is being lost. It is being lost on the second and third and fourth generation. Why? Because they feel comfortable that their roots are there, but I'm telling them, we need your help, we need your support. Tomorrow, we have an event on September 11th on the legislature steps at 5:30. I call on all Latin Americans, I call all the people who defend human rights that tomorrow, the 45th anniversary of the coup, we need you. We need you every time. And that's one event. The second event's on Saturday, on the 15th, a full commemoration indoors at the Ukrainian Center. We have a Ukrainian brother right here, full support from the Ukrainian Center. And from the, this movement is not just a movement of one country. This is a movement of the full greater ideology for human rights, for solidarity, and that we can never stop. We have a pillar of our community right here in Sandra Socar. Sandra Socar not only has fought for many different organizations, but now she is the head of one of the largest and strongest defenders for healthcare. And I'm proud to introduce Sandra Socar for a special presentation next, because her father, her mother have fought from beginning to end and document what everybody has done here. Para todos mis tías y tíos, gracias. Gracias por lo que hicieron. Gracias por el trabajo que hicieron. Esta lucha no para ahora. Sigue. Y tenemos que apoyar. Tenemos que empujar tus hijos para seguir el trabajo. Ahora viene el trabajo. No lo podemos parar ahora. So right now I want to, for my sake,
compañero Salvador Allende,
presente.
Compañero Salvador Allende,
presente.
Ahora,
y siempre.
Ahora,
y siempre.
Gracias. I call on Sandra Soca now to do a special presentation. Sandra, por favor.
Thank you. This is going to be very quick. I just wanted to thank all the staff that made this possible. This is a very, very important moment for our community, for the future generations. You know, just as recently as a month or so ago, the Minister of Culture in Chile said that the remembering, all the remembrance that was happening with the building of the Museum of Human Rights in Chile was a montage to make people be shocked into not being able to reason. For us, that's a slap in the face. We've lived exile since 1973. We've lived in Canada as a result of what happened to our parents, what happened to our comrades in Chile. And for us, it's important that we have the opportunity to create collective memory, to continue to grow our community, to provide it with a solid foundation from which they can continue to grow history, continue to make history, continue to make a community. We were here for a specific reason. We were exiled. We, the majority of Chileans that came in 1970s, didn't come out of free choice. You know, there's so much talk about refugees and why it is that they're coming. Well, we've lived through that. We were the unwanted at one point, and that goes to show that things don't change. And unless communities like us, who have been here for a long time, continue to bring those that history alive, then certainly it's going to continue to happen. I'm very proud to be able to share this with the Minister of Culture, like the Honorable Ricardo Miranda. For me personally, this has a very important meaning. This is a reflection of the work that my dad did for years, for decades, to continue to maintain our history, to continue the connection that we had with Latin America, to continue the connection that we had with the fight for human rights and everything that was just. It's a continuation of the work that all of our tios and tias did, all those that believe that society could be better, the dreamers that actually dream with their feet firmly planted on the ground because they knew that a society could be and must do better for its people. And so This is my dad's work, and I'm very, very happy to be able to share this with you and with Albertans. Thank you so much.
Me van a permitir unos minutos. Voy a empezar para agradecerles a todos por estar aquí esta mañana. I want to thank you all for being here this morning. I too acknowledge that we are an indigenous land, Treaty 6, also land that is very important to the Métis people of our province. And I also would like to thank all the people who have for many years fought for human rights, because this is something that has been going on for many, many generations. I understand this. I am Latin American. I am also Jewish. And I know a long, long history of persecution because people are different, because people have different beliefs. And that, for some reason, allows people to believe that it is okay to discriminate, that it's okay to oppress, that it's okay to silence people's voices. La historia de Chile para mí fue, y para muchos en la América Latina, fue muy importante. La música de jarra que acabamos de escuchar en mi país natal de Nicaragua fue prohibida, no se permitía en las radios, no se permitía en las escuelas, no se permitía en ningún lugar público, porque hablaba de un futuro mejor, hablaba de una mejor manera de existir, una mejor manera de convivir. So the music, the song that we just heard in where I was born, Nicaragua, was actually forbidden to be played on the radio or anywhere in public. In fact, if you did play it, you would actually most likely end up in jail and most likely disappeared as a result, because it was seen as not helpful to coexistence, I believe the words that were being used at the time. And I think that it's such an incredible thing to be able to hear it in this place that collects the historic memory of our province, because of course the people of Chile did not come here out of choice. Most of Latin Americans do not leave their countries out of choice. I know personally that I have been here for many, many years. I came here as a refugee, and I did not leave it because I had a choice. And unfortunately, the situation in Latin America continues to be very much the same. My mother was in Nicaragua not too long ago, where protests have turned violent and repression, and people have gone missing, and there's over 400 people killed as a result. And when I asked my mother to please come back, she basically said to me, in 1986, I did not feel I had a choice. I had children. I had you, I had your brothers and sisters. And today I have a choice, and I am going to stay. And quickly, they pushed her out. They would not allow her to stay, in fact. And they wanted her out, and so she came back, and now she's telling the stories. And you know, when I think about all the pain and the hurt that the people of Chile went through, they set an example for the rest of Latin America of what it means to be indomable, completamente, siempre fiente, siempre fuertes y siempre buscando una mejor manera de coexistir con todos. Es un país con una gente muy noble que luchó por sus derechos, por la osadía de querer expresar sus derechos democráticos, que es algo que todo el mundo tiene el derecho a hacer. To me, it's the most noble thing to be able to be here and listen to the stories and understand the history, because it teaches us about what's happening today. And in fact, we have seen this story over and over again in many different places. And having this here will not only be for the people of Chile, the Chilean community in this province, it'll be as an example for everybody in this province to understand why people leave their homes and why people are here, and the struggles, and understand the need for solidarity, the need to work together and participate in this work of human rights to ensure that every single person has the right to freedom and expression and democracy. So today I'm truly humbled and honored to be here to receive these records on behalf of the government of Alberta. And I thank you so very much for having done this and for sharing your painful but admirable and noble stories with us.
Thank you very much, Minister. Next, I'd like to introduce MLA Rod Loyola, who will speak on about his experiences.
Hola a todos y todas. First, I'd like to also acknowledge that we are on Treaty 6 territory, but also part of that acknowledgement is understanding that Indigenous people have welcomed us here. And through the signing of the treaty with the Crown, have basically acknowledged that we share this land, and that we need to be responsible to one another in making sure to uphold those treaties, and that we are all treaty people. And we need to understand what that really means as a visiting community, a community of people who have come as refugees. We also have a responsibility, especially us who know what it's like to have our human rights taken away. We can't, as Sergio said very well, we can't continue to allow this to happen over and over again through our history. So as we remember our own and commemorate our own history of exile and the refugees, we also have to take into consideration the history of others and the oppression and repression that they have experienced right here on this land, as we continue to build a better Alberta and a better Canada for all people. So let us not forget that we are all treaty people. I also wanted to say thank you to my tios and tias, because of course it is you who helped me become the person that I am today and give me the confidence to eventually put my name forward so that I could run in the last provincial election, which ended up with the very first time in the history of Alberta, a new democratic government in the province of Alberta. And of course, we continue to make history. I feel privileged to be the very first Chilean to be elected to the Legislative Assembly of Alberta, and of course, one of three Latin Americans to be elected to the provincial legislature in the history of Alberta. We're doing incredible things. Yes, please feel free to applaud. That's something to applaud. And of course, this is significant because not only has this government done its very best to make sure that there is more representation from people, but making sure that we have more women in government as well. We're very proud to be part of a cabinet and caucus that's 50% women, and that we continue to grow. And the fact that, for example, the agencies, boards, and commissions, which actually control 50% of the provincial budget, before the NDP being elected, was basically, and I'll say it flat out, an old white boys club. There wasn't a lot of women on these agencies, boards, and commissions. And one of the things that we did was we did our very best to make the process a transparent one, where people could apply for these positions, and then it was our goal to make sure that there was 50% women on these agencies, boards, and commissions, and not only women, but also more representation from cultural communities that call Alberta home. Because, of course, the Alberta of today is very different than the Alberta of 40 years ago. Now, you may be wondering, well, why am I saying all these things on this particular day? And the reason why I'm saying these things and why it's been so important for me to fight for those things within this government is because of the legacy of Salvador Allende. As you well know, and what you inculcated in me through the teachings that you passed on to me, was that we need to build a better society. A society that truly respects the dignity of the human person, where everybody feels that they belong. And that's the kind of Alberta that we're building right now under Premier Rachel Notley and her cabinet. We're making sure that it's a province where everybody feels included. And yes, we have a lot of work to do when it comes to Indigenous issues, whether it comes to health care, but we're on the right track. We're getting there. And we need to continue making sure that the legacy of Salvador Allende, us as Chileans in this province, continues to ring true. At every school that I have the opportunity to go to, and every time that children come to the legislature to visit me, I tell them one important thing, and that our democracy is only as strong as the number of people that participate in it. You can have a democracy, but if you don't have people participating in it, like the people of Chile participated during the years of the Salvador Allende government, then what kind of democracy is it really? So we need to continue encouraging people here in the province of Alberta and in this great country of Canada to continue strengthening democracy, making sure that people feel that they're being listened to, making sure that they feel part of the political process and the decision-making processes of their government. So I'm very proud that I continue in the footsteps of Salvador Allende, our community that has done so much, and you can guarantee that I'll continue working hard to do exactly that. The last note I want to leave you on is that what I learned from the community is that we're a movement. We're a social movement. And it's so important to get out there and connect with other people involved in other social movements. And the reason for why, because a political party, as we all know, is an instrument to take political power. But it must be the voice of the people. So that's where social movements, every 4 years, go and attempt to take that political power. That's the lesson that I learned from you, my tios and tias. So we need to keep fighting. Let's keep doing our best. Let's keep building a better Alberta. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, MLA Loyola. Next, I'd like to introduce Member of Parliament Linda Duncan. Linda, please.
A very emotional day for the community here at Edmonton. I too want to recognize we're on Treaty 6 lands, but I also want to recognize all the people who have chosen to come to our country, to our province, and to our city. And I thank you. I thank you that you chose to come to Canada. What a remarkable day that those who are bringing these treasures of archive to archives, here I say proudly in Edmonton Strathcona, as a member of Parliament for Edmonton Strathcona, I'm a great lover of archives. We look what just happened in Brazil, the burning of a museum. It's not just a building, it's not just objects. It's the memory of what happened and how we became who we are. And I am so grateful to our archives, to our government, for recognizing the importance of this. And the important message is there are probably additional treasures out there that the community have not yet been able to collect, and those need to be included in this treasure. But think about this day. Think about this day of who are presenting this treasure. Three representatives who came as refugees from Latin America to our city, and two of whom are members of our government. We think about that, the first Chilean in the government, perhaps the first Nicaraguan. That is what our community should be. That is what our government should be. That is what the representation should be, because that is who we are. And I am so grateful that I can bring your voices forward. When I stood in the House of Commons supporting the motion for a Latin American Day, well, it wasn't very difficult because of the treasures that I have here in my own city. They don't just run restaurants and run festivals. They are working for change. They're working for democracy so that we don't repeat the mistakes that have happened in other nations. We know that it's not just Venezuela, it's not just Nicaragua, it's not Salvador, it's Ukraine, it's Syria. You represent the best of the best of who Canadians are. And I am so proud to have reached out and said, Sandra Azakar should be a spokesperson when the Standing Committee on Finance comes to our city, because she can say why we need more support for Medicare. The work that the members of the Latin American community have done in our city and in our country to build a better world, I cannot thank you enough. And I am so grateful that this archive will be here. I'm sure that in many of those marches, I was there. If I couldn't be there, I was there in spirit. And it breaks my heart what happened. It breaks my heart. So many still do not understand why people had to leave and why it's so important still to have governments that will stand up for the rights for all, the equality for all, and the recognition of all who continue to contribute to society. So thank you so much for donating this to the Alberta Archives.
Once again, I would like to welcome Daniel Villalobos to the stage, and thank you very much, MP Duncan, for those remarks. Daniel.
Well, once again, 45 years of resistance, 45 years that we keep fighting, and we keep searching for that better world. We keep searching for that answer, for that way of giving the best life possible to our friends, our family, our sons, our children. And it doesn't stop. It doesn't stop today. It doesn't stop with this. We just keep going. And we must gather all this information and all of our experiences to be able to build that better future. That means to be a better person, a better society for our future generations. So once again, thank you to all the politicians here present. Thank you to all Latinos and Latias. We funded Memoria Viva about 10 years ago now, and at 40 years we did an amazing project that we all enjoyed. It was a theater play that brought all the people together. And 5 years after that, here we are. So yes, we're here, we're still standing, and we're standing strong, and nobody will ever let us down. So our last song, Victor Jara, for me, it's the reason I learned guitar. Victor Jara, for me, is the reason why I opened up my eyes to a whole Latin America, because he founded that movement on the 60s and 70s of making Latin American folklore music and all that accessible to everybody, and at the same time bring the voice of justice to the people. And what better way to bring that word justice than the arts, right? So the last song is called El Arao. I don't know the name in English. The plow, just like the plow, like the farmers, you know, plow day in, day out, and just like we need to plow the way of our roads and of our lives. So here we go.
Hace años que llevo en ella como nuestra gota. Afirmo bien la esperanza cuando pienso en la otra estrella. Nunca es tarde, me dice ella, la paloma vola. Las mariposas cantan grillos, la piel se me pone negra y el sol brilla, brilla y brilla. El sudor me hace surcos, yo hago surcos a la tierra sin parar. Vuelan mariposas, cantan grillos, la piel se me pone negra y el sol brilla, brilla y brilla. Y en las tardes cuando vuelvo, en el cielo apareciendo una estrella. Afirmo bien la esperanza cuando pienso en la otra estrella. Nunca es tarde, me dice ella, la paloma vola. Vuelan mariposas, cantan grillos, la piel se me pone negra y el sol brilla, brilla y brilla. El sudor me hace surcos, yo hago surcos a la tierra sin parar. Nunca es tarde, me dice ella, la paloma volará, volará, volará. Como el yugo de apretado, tengo el puño esperanzao, porque todo cambiará.
Ladies and gentlemen, muchas gracias. Thank you very much for sharing the space. Thank you, Alberta. Thank you, Canada.